Hello and welcome to my channel. I'm Madhurima Sharma and today I'm going to talk about communication research. So let's start. So first we will discuss about research. What is research? So research comprised of two words, re and search. That means sending it again and again. In common terms means search for knowledge, and it is a systematic process of collecting and analyzing information to increase our understanding of the phenomenon under study. According to Redman and Murray, research is a systematized effort to gain new knowledge. And according to Clifford Udy, research comprises defining and redefining problem, formulating hypothesis or suggested solutions, collecting, organizing and evaluating data, making deduction and reaching conclusion, and finally carefully testing the conclusions to determine whether they fit the formulated hypothesis. So this is a very well known definition of research. So let's understand it in a very simple way. So it is simply a systematic inquiry. You want to know more about a particular topic, so you go through a process to increase your knowledge. Like in everyday life, everyone do research, from writing theses and research paper to deciding and designing apparels for a model for a fashion show. Even when we talk to any known or unknown person, we do research. Knowing about him, searching about his likes and dislikes and background of the unknown person especially, we involve in a research only. So it is actually a creation of a knowledge, new knowledge, and use of a existing knowledge in a new and a creative way to generate a new concept. So communication research, this is the topic. What is communication research? So communication or a media research is a study of medium or a mass media like radio, television, print media and new media for the purpose of reaching the consumer or the audience. So communication research is conducted to clarify the communication process and help us to understand the importance of communication in our life. And it is a research centered on an issue of media selection and efficiency. Media selection here means how and why the producer of the message or content select the media channel. That means he must select the channel or a medium for the target audience for making some impact to fulfill his or her purpose. And efficiency, if the selected channel or the coded or the produced message or a program is efficient, and how the audience will respond to the message or content. It is the efficiency. So communication research is conducted to help people understand complex and challenging communication phenomenon, as well as the mundane and apparently simple everyday routine like an ordinary conversation. So we can say communication research is an attempt to discover trend and fact in a field of communication and a mass media. Like, research about communication is needed for two reasons. First is to extend the growth of the communication discipline and to apply what we know. So in communication research, what we do, like we analyze the channel, message and the audience. In message analysis, we want to know what kind of message we will disseminate to the target audience. For understandable message, it must be short and simple and clear. And in channel analysis, how and where the product should be sold, or we can say how and where the message should be sent, and what channel we should select for the audience, target audience. And the audience analysis is about the gathering and analyzing the information about the receiver, your target audience. So concept, now we will discuss concept and construct of the communication research. So what is concept? Concept are more important in a field of communication research, as they simplify the research process by combining different characteristics, object or people into more general categories. And concept has been described as a basic building block or an idea of theory and a research. So simply you can understand, concept are a mental boxes in which we throw things what we think have importance in our life. For example, concept of education. So concept of education has all sort of things we observe in the world around us, like school, libraries, life experience, etc. So whatever we observe, we organize it in a general pattern. So according to Curlinger, a concept is a term that expresses an abstraction or an abstract idea formed by generalization from a particular. And according to Wimmer and Dominic, concepts are important because they facilitate communication among those who have a shared understanding of them. And researchers use concepts to organize their observation into a meaningful summaries and to transmit this information to academic community. In addition, since concepts are abstracted from observation, they enable researchers to look for a general explanation or pattern in observation. And since we know concepts are abounded in the mass communication, for example, they include media uses, media imperialism, cultural imperialism, agenda setting, selective attention, retention, perception, media effects, and monopolization. So these all are concepts. Now, what is construct? Construct is an abstract idea that usually is broken down into dimensions represented by lower level concepts. And construct can be combination of several concepts. It cannot be observed directly. It is designed for the purpose or in the context of the study. According to Curlinger, a construct is also a concept. However, it has added meaning of having been deliberately and consciously invented or adopted for a specific scientific purpose. So constructs have been described as a higher concept. And according to Wimmer and Dominic, construct is a combination of concepts created for a particular scientific purpose. And constructs are generally difficult to observe directly. Their existence therefore must be inferred from a related behavioral pattern. For example, edutainment is a construct comprising two concepts, education and entertainment. Education is also a concept, entertainment is also a concept, and these two becomes a construct. So please remember, first thing, it is an abstract idea and construct are a higher concepts. Now, approaches to communication research. Next is inductive research approach. Inductive approach is moving from specific observation to a broader generalization and theories. Informally, we sometimes call this bottom-up approach. Conclusion is likely based on premises and it involves a degree of uncertainty because inductive arguments are meant to predict the conclusion. Here we are predicting the conclusion, okay, from the premises. So here are some examples, then it will be more clear to you what is deductive and inductive argument or what is deductive and inductive research approach. Here in deductive, all philosophers have a brain. Bob is a philosopher, therefore Bob has a brain. That means here we are moving from general to specific. General here is all philosopher has brain. Since Bob is a philosopher, Bob has a brain. So this is specific. Or inductive, where we can see most philosophers have brain. So most, not every, most philosophers have brain. Sam is a philosopher, so Sam probably has brain. Here we are moving from specific to general, specification to generalization. Next example is in deductive, all eagles can fly. Since Tweety is an eagle, therefore Tweety can fly. So here we are moving from general, that is all eagle can fly, to Tweety can fly, that is specific. And in inductive approach, you can see every year we get thunderstorm in a May. Since it is a May, so we will get thunderstorm. Here, every year we get a thunderstorm in May is a specific, and we will get thunderstorm in a May is a general concept. So here is a prediction of the conclusion. We are predicting here only. Now, what is abductive research approach? See, abductive approach is said to address weakness associated with deductive and the inductive approach. So, abductive is similar to deductive and inductive approach in a way that is applied to make logical inference and construct theories. And in abductive approach, the research process starts with surprising fact or puzzle, and the research process is devoted their explanation. In abductive reasoning involves deciding what the most likely inference is that can be made from a set of observation. Here, from the incomplete observation, we move to the best prediction that may be true. So here's one example. Observation is, the grass outside my window was wet when I woke up this morning. As we know, this fact is known, rain in the night can make grass wet. But abductive inference is that there was probably rain at night. So this may not be reason, or this may be the reason. So here there are so many possible reason for the grass was wet when he woke up in the morning and saw that. So abductive reasoning is important because there is often many or infinite number of possible explanation for a phenomenon. So you need some way to decide which possible explanation to look at first. So here in image you can see, in abductive reasoning, incomplete observation, from incomplete observation moving to best prediction that may be true. In deductive approach, you can see from general to specific conclusion that is always true. And in inductive, from specific observation to general conclusion that may be true, but here there is a prediction of that. Now there is difference between deductive, inductive and abduction. So in deductive inference, when premises are true, the conclusion must be true. So this is the logic in deductive reasoning or in deductive approach. When premises are true, the conclusion must be true. And in inductive approach, known premises are used to generate the untested conclusion. And in abductive, known premises are used to generate a testable conclusion. Then generalizability, generalizing from general to specific. In inductive, from specific to general. And in abduction, generalizing from interaction between the specific and the general. Now the use of data, the data collection used in to evaluate proposition or a hypothesis related to existing theory. In inductive, data collection is used to explore a phenomenon, identify themes and pattern and create a conceptual framework. And in abduction, data collection is used to explore a phenomenon, identify themes and pattern, locate these in a conceptual framework and test these through subsequent data collection and so forth. Theory mein, it is used for theory falsification and or verification. Inductive mein, theory generating for theory generation and building. And in abduction, theory generation or modification incorporating existing theory where appropriate and to build new theory or modify the existing theory. So this is the difference between the deduction, induction and abduction. So this is a homework. You can actually solve this. You have to identify the following argument as inductive or deductive. First is, human usually use new technology in time of war to destroy instead of build. The atomic bomb is a great example. Therefore, we will probably use strong artificial intelligence to destroy in times of war if we ever invent. You have to identify if it is an inductive or deductive approach. Next is, there are two people in this house, Ram and Shyam. Neither wear glass, therefore Ram doesn't wear glass. Next is, if God exists, there is a good in the world. God exists, so there is a good in the world. Fourth is, since every action has an equal and opposite reaction, this action will have an equal and opposite reaction. Fifth, Bob is taller than his wife and his wife is taller than his son, so Bob is taller than his son. Now you have to find out which of the following argument is inductive or deductive. So you can comment me. Okay, chalo. I hope you like this video. Like, subscribe and share to my channel. Thank you so much.